Asha. Welcome back to my channel. Before I say anything else, make sure to hit that subscribe button, and after you do, a little bell will pop up so you can hit that and you'll be notified anytime I upload a new video. It's free. Today's video, I'm going to be, of course, reviewing the Jaclyn Hill palette because everyone has been getting it now. And I'm going to be including my teeny wee red gloss in the video because, as you can see, it like sets the whole entire eye look. And I really don't know what like kind of eye look I'm doing. I'm just going to put some shadows together and just shadows that will make my brown eyes pop. The best thing is that you could really use any kind of warm color eyeshadow to really make those brown eyes pop, even like a purple eyeshadow, and that's what I was kind of going for, like a smoky brown shadow kind of look with like some red in it, and I think it looks really amazing. I hope you guys like it, and let's get started. I'm going to go in with this color right here. And that is going to be the color for my lid because, I don't really know what color or what eye look I'm going for, but I'm just going to test out the colors that I really love and that bring out my brown eyes. So I think first I'm going to spray it a little so it's more pigmented because I want that like pop on the eyes. Just going to wet it a little, more like a lot, but it's okay. I'm just going to take some crayon apple and put it on the lids. Oh my gosh. That is beautiful. It feels very buttery. So wait, let me. Okay, that is much better. And buttery and pigmented is what I could ask for, just like all I could ask for in an eyeshadow. That is so pretty, but obviously we need to add some more colors, more like into the crease. That's what I'm talking about. For the transition shade, and this is surprising, like I never do this, but for the transition shade, what I'm pointing to, that gold shimmery pretty color, and I'm gonna be just putting that as a transition shade. Oh, that is so pretty. I don't want to get any eyeshadows like messed up. I want to like keep it going with the kind of like winged eyeshadow that's going on right there. So what I'm going to do is take some translucent powder, a brush, dip it in, going to just put it on the edges. Just because I don't want any like mess up on the beautiful wings that I have going on. Now I'll go back with that color, with the color Queen, and I am going to just be continuing to put that color in the crease. And I usually build up from the crease to the lids, but this time, since I really want to focus on like the lids going to like the outer crease, I did the lids first, and then I'm going to do the outer crease to the inner crease. And to help not get the shadows too far up, I'm raising my eyebrow. Going down, I'm not going like up when I usually blend up. I'm blending it down. Now the next color I'm going to go in with is the color Mocha, and that is the color that is the last one on the second, I mean on the second to last. It's the last one, the second to last, right here. And I'm going to be using that color to build out the smoky area. So I'm going to be starting here, just dabbing it a tiny bit, and bringing it slowly, slowly into the crease. I'm gonna go in with the color Hunt, and it's like a brick dark red, and it's rich. It's gonna be amazing. And I will show you what color that is. It is this color that is right over here. I'm gonna be using that to just finish the whole crease. Going to be just filling it all out from the outer crease right here and going all the way to the inner crease. So now, since we got the crease, I am going to go back to that area, but first I'm going to go to the lower lashes and I'm going to make it even. And in order to make it even, I'm going to take Mocha and put it just on the bottom lashes. Because you see where that wing is, like up there? I'm going to connect it. So I got a smaller brush and I'm going to take that Hunt color. Is it called Hunt? Hunt, excuse me. It's called Hunt on the bottom lashes, lash line. I'm going to be going in one more time onto my lids with the color Cranapple. I'm in love with this look. I am obsessed! To finish up the eye look before the lashes, I am going to take this beautiful white pearly color right here, and I'm going to be highlighting my brow bone because this is just going to finish it up, make it look gorgeous. Oh my gosh. Oh my god. Do you see that? Oh, that is gorgeous. So now I'm going to be right back and have my lashes on, and then I will tell you what I think of this palettes. So I am back with the lashes on and now to finish off the whole entire look with my Teeny Wee red gloss. So that is the whole look and I am in love with the shadows and how I put it together. And the red gloss really like sets everything together. It's really great. So get your red glosses also. They don't run and they're very pigmented. They stay on a long time and it could go on top of a red lip liner or it could go by itself as you could see. I didn't do it with the red lip liner because I didn't need one. And there is a fly in here. I really hope it's not a mosquito. I'm like so bitten all over my arm and it sucks. It really sucks. So I really hope this doesn't bite me anytime soon, because if it does, I will bite it back. No, I'm just kidding. I won't. That'd be really gross. So again, I really hope you guys liked this video. If you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up and comment down below if you want me to do any more reviews because this was so much fun. And comment down below the next makeup transformation you guys want me to do because it's my thing. And I will talk to you guys in my next video. I love you all so much. And yeah, okay, bye princesses. Mwah.